Hello everyone. Today I'm going to guide you on how to create a partition to install Windows, just like installing from a USB, right on your hard drive. First, right-click on the Windows icon and open Disk Management. Please shrink a partition by about 10 gigabytes to hold the Windows installation files there. Click on Shrink Volume and enter 10240 to create the 10 gigabytes partition. Now you will have a 10 gigabytes free partition. Right-click on it and select New Simple Volume. Please choose the letter W for this partition, format the file system as FAT32, and set the label as Windows Setup. So, now you have a drive W with a size of 10 gigabytes. Now, double-click on the Windows 1125 H2 ISO file to mount it to the virtual drive. Now, copy all the files inside here to the drive W you just created. The install.vim file will not be able to be copied. Just click Skip so it can continue. Now I will access the virtual drive where the ISO file was mounted to find the location of the install.vim file. You can find it in the sources folder. So my install.vim file has the path F, sources, install.vim. Now I will open CMD as administrator to split this install.vim file into smaller files to accommodate the FAT32 partition. I will place the command in the description or comments section of the video. So, we have successfully split the install.vim file into smaller files. Now I'll check to see if the install.swm file is in the W partition. As you can see, the install.vim file has been split into install.swm and install2.swm. This means it was successful. Next, I will create a file to bypass the hardware check during Windows 11 installation. Open a new Notepad file and paste the content I have already prepared into it. Now, select File, Save As, save it on Drive W with the name bypass.reg, and select the type of file as All Files. So, I now have the file to bypass it. Now I will download a tool called Bootice and run the x64 version of the software. Now, open it with administrator. Now, switch to the UEFI tab and select Edit Boot Entries. Click Add. Now, navigate to W, then EFI, then boot, and select the file boot64.fe. Now, name this entry Windows 1125 H2 Setup. And please pay attention to the boot part section. You must select the correct 10 gigabytes FAT32 partition that we created. After you're done, just click Save Current Boot Entry to complete. Now, click Restart and open your computer's boot menu to see if the new entry is there. You can see that the Windows 1125 H2 setup is here. Select it and open it. As you can see, I have successfully booted into the Windows setup. Now I will proceed with the installation as usual. Please pay close attention to the next step, where we select the hard drive. You can see that my machine does not meet the requirements for installing Windows 11. Press Shift and F10 on the keyboard to open the command prompt. I will open Notepad and select File, then open to find the bypass file that I just created. Here, I will select the file of type as all files so I can view the .reg extension, and then I will go into the WinStup drive to find it. Right-click on the bypass file and select Merge. So, I have successfully bypassed the hardware requirements check. Now I will move on to the next step. In this hard drive selection step, please select the correct partition where you want to install Windows and click Format. Selecting the wrong one will result in data loss, and you must absolutely not delete the WinStup partition. So, I have successfully installed Windows. To quickly create a local account, press Shift and F10 on the keyboard to bring up the command prompt and enter the command displayed on the screen. Now just enter the name and you're done. So, we are now inside Windows. Next, I will check my partitions. As you can see, I have three partitions: C for Windows, D used for installing Windows, and E for data storage. Next, I will hide the D partition so it can be reused for the next Windows installation. Right-click on the Windows icon and select Disk Management. Right-click on the WinStup partition and select Change Drive Letter and Paths. I will click Remove to delete the letter. And now I will change the data partition's letter to D. So, I have successfully hidden the WinSetup partition. Next, I will restart the computer and see if it can still boot into the setup. As you can see, I can still boot into WinSetup normally. Now I will exit and go back into Windows. So, the video is complete. If you like this video, please leave me a like and subscribe to the channel to look forward to more interesting videos about Windows. Have a great day.